right, talk through what we got going on here.
Oh, well, today could be the big day. We're going to try to put the last few things together, and if we get to it, try to fire this thing off. We're getting ready to pre-oil it with lube that baby up real good, you know. It needs to be nice and lubed. So we're going to put a down the distributor hole, spin that, try to get oil pressure up there, and then button that up, and then dial in the new HEI distributor, hook up a bunch of hoses, and see if this old 327 will come to life. That's what we're hoping for. This thing is just laying loose, so I don't think it's going to hurt nothing. There's nothing really hooked up to it. Well, there's vacuum hooked up to it, but I've not bench bled that yet.
That should be all right.
I see the possible obstruction here or something.
What do you see?
Well, I just see this power steering bolt. It looks like it might be hit. We may not even run this today.
It's probably because we have the engine jacked up right now. So once the back goes down, it'll be fine.
Maybe so.
The front is up right
maybe
now.
Maybe so, because it seems like it's hitting on that shroud.
I saw that happening once we...
Mm-hmm. Is this my beer now?
Nope, that's mine.
I was trying to see which one had the most.
What did we get done so far?
Oh my God. Well, we got tore up knuckles, burned. We're pretty good. We've been mechanicking all morning. We got wounds to show for it.
Anything else besides wounds?
Well, let's see. We've got, we actually got the transmission cooler lines installed, which was a custom deal where we had to adapt them to this car. So we got that, got the cooler, the tranny cooler mounted up there on zip ties. So this ought to be really good. Let's see what else. We got the whole thing braced so it doesn't like eat itself alive as soon as the fan starts hitting the shroud. So we got that braced with a piece of wood. Let's see. We got more transmission fluid in it, and most importantly, we got the distributor down it. We pre-oiled the motor, we pre-oiled it, brought it up to about 20-30 pounds of pressure, and now we put the distributor in, and we got to do a little tweaking here to get that exactly the timing in, but I think we're about there. We're going to put a little juice in the radiator. Alternator is all, and all that wiring is rudimentary at best, but I think maybe we'll find out, by God, if it works or not. We're ready. We're going to get the fire extinguisher just in case, because I'm afraid that sometimes we see smoke come up from this kind of work. And when the smoke comes up, you got to run for something to put it out with, because otherwise it's not a good thing. It's not a good thing at all when you see that wire starts to smoke.
How confident are you with the wiring that's been done here today?
On a scale of what?
On a scale of 1 to 10.
Oh, about a 4.
Okay. Well, that'll be good.
That's your wiring. That's why I say that.
I know.
Okay. All right. That way, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Possibly. Maybe. Or maybe it comes this way, actually.
Something, yeah. Anyway, how are we looking on the electrical?
Look, it looks like your usual spaghetti. But, well, I don't know. I hope it's good.
The battery's connected now, so how are we looking?
Yeah, there's no smoke. There's no visible smoke. That's all I can report
good.
At this stage. But we're prepared for smoke.
Okay, I heard something click. Okay, hold on.
Okay, I got a ignition light. Your brake light's splashing up here.
Okay, turn it off for a second. Turn it back on. I'm just looking for smoke.
I know. so the idiot lights on the
which is what we want. I want on to be on, which is looking like we're right so far. If I get this, if this is right, this is going to be a freaking miracle. Okay, I mean, that means that the electrical system is at least powered and grounded, so we're okay there, since there's a light. Maybe give it just the quickest bump.
Nothing.
Okay, go back.
Okay, nothing happening there.
So we have the American Auto Wire harness, but for some reason the starter wire, the purple wire from the ignition switch assembly didn't work. So we basically had to jumper it with that white wire right there.
Yeah, right.
All the way to the starter.
It's not the first damn time we've had stuff right off the shelf that was bunk, right? So
makes it hard to troubleshoot, doesn't it?
No shit, right? You trust stuff you buy. But you know what? It's a slippery slope, because stuff you buy brand new doesn't necessarily mean it's going to work right away. It could be defective, and often is, actually. That's the sad part. Yeah.
Okay, well, let's see if we can get this going.
All righty. Well, we've rewired it, got new harness, and got her to turn when it's supposed to turn and not turn when it's not supposed to turn. We're up to a point now where we can't get fuel to the car. So that's fairly straightforward. There's either a blockage or we had it sucking air through the line. So we're going to try it again.
Go.
Here we go.
Not yet, keep going. Keep going, no fuel.
There's gotta be a blockage.
Well, I don't know yet. Do it one more time.
Okay.
Nothing coming through yet. Yeah. Me through what we just did.
Oh my god. Well, we couldn't get gas to the carburetor, so there's only one thing that could have been. It was a blockage in the main line from the tank, which is brand new. I put the brand new tank in. Blockage in the existing line, so up to the fuel pump. So there you go. We cleaned it. We blew that bitch out, so now it's ready to go again, I think.
So now we want to see you crank it, and we want to see fuel.
We do. We want
right
to
there.
See it. Just skew.
Go for it. Keep going. Keep going.
Go. Oh my God, it's warm.
What do we got?
What do we got? We're going to go at it again. This time we got a little electric fuel pump plumbed in here to try to get fuel to that carburetor. And it will get fuel to the carburetor. You can see it's got fuel in it right now. So it wants to run. We know that. We've had it to fire, but wouldn't sustain itself. So now we're going to try to sustain itself. Get it to sustain itself on artificial pumping, and then we're going to try plumbing in the mechanical fuel pump, which we couldn't get to work the other day, but we'll try it again. We're always wanting to get this thing going. This might be it, by God, you know. We're trying today. This is take three or four on this, firing this 327.
All right, let's get it.
Okay.
You have coolant, you have oil, you have everything else.
I do.
Okay.
Okay.
Go ahead. Right. Yep.
She's wanting to.
Okay, hold on. Hold on. I'm seeing fuel.
Uh-huh.
I'm seeing fuel, I'm hearing fuel. Hold on. Okay. Yeah, although it's not filling up, really filling up, but go ahead.
Well, it's not cheap, but it's header paint.
Let's get a little fresh air.
No kidding, right? Woo, dog. That's what a hot rod's all about, breathing them fumes and poison fumes.
Turn your hat backwards so I can see you. How do you feel?
I feel good. I got it going. We got it going. But, yeah, that's great. That's great. It fired right up it, like, instantly.
Not even
I told
hesitation.
You she wanted to run. She wanted to start so bad. She did. Exactly.
That's ideal.
Yeah, what a day, eh?
There you go. High five.
That's a beer drinking day right there, by God.
Yeah, it is.
That's great. That's really good. That's a long time coming.
Yeah.
That's a real long time coming. I'm a little heady after them fumes. Well, today we got brakes on it, and we got the transmission dialed in, so it shifts all the way up through all the whole gears. That's a good deal on a custom shifter linkage. Put the whole brake system together in here. Look at that new dual master cylinder. Got all the everything going. Bled it all out.
New lines.
Hey, She's ready. And what else can we do? Oh, well, hell yeah. Look at that. Fenders, hood. By God. She's a car again.
Won't be long. We'll be driving this sucker.
It's really true about this one wants to run. She wants to run bad. And nobody wants her to run bad, more bad than I do. More badly. Very badly, I want it. But yeah, look at that. It's coming along. Mm-hmm. It looks like the same car came in here, but, you know, actually it's not. It's got new guts.
Well, yeah. Till next time.
Until next time, yep. Yeah.